Okay, so this is the last part of the recording. I'm going to show you the possible output for the Litera Club. So one is regarding the island studies. So this is from the Department of Social Sciences at the University of the Philippines at Manila. So this is about area studies and ethnic studies. So this is edited by Dr. Jose, Dr. Navarro, and Professor Ong. So they are the editors. So this was published in 2021. So it's no secret that this is my wish for MAR-SU to contribute to the knowledge production of the programs that we offer. So this is the title page and also the copyright page. So with the ISBN and ISSN, so they have a print and they have an online edition. So the book designer, the layout artist, and even the person in charge, like editing, would be credited in the book. So the content are as follows. There are articles that were collated. So this time about not only island studies, but also area studies and ethnic studies. So because in the UP Manila, in the social sciences department, they have the program area studies. So that's why they have this following article. So one article is about the program in area studies at UP Manila, area studies and ethnic studies in the context of social sciences and in the contemporary period. And also there's a particular article about comparison and contrast of women writers, and there's a valuation of ethnic studies, so Araling Kabanwaan in the context of globalization and far right. So this is not a translation, so there are discourses that are actively discuss in the book, and after which there are a couple of commentaries from the cultural agency. So one is from Mr. Lawrence Salazar, I believe, from the National Commission for Culture and the Arts, and another one regarding ASEAN. And at the end of the book, there is a bio note of the contributing writers and authors. So as mentioned, these are the parts of the book. So the preliminary, the introduction, and the respective articles that were collated to comprise the entirety of the book. So I hope that at the end of the semester, we'd be able to produce enough number of articles that are worth publishing. And since what you are taking this semester is pop culture, so there's also an output regarding pop culture, but this time in the ASEAN context. So this is the output also of Dr. Jose, of Professor Atoy, and Professor Ong from the same department, from the social sciences of UP Manila. So it's more recent, just last year, 2023. And by this, you'd be able to compare and contrast the structure. So of course, there's a title page, a copyright notice. You'd see here ISBN due to the publication, from the application to the National Library. And of course, the table of contents. So there is a preliminary, a preface, an introduction, and the articles. So 1, 2, 3, 4 articles, and instead of commentaries, there's a conclusion, and just the same, there is also a notes on the contributing authors and writers. So just to browse the topics that were discussed in the book, the pop culture in the ASEAN context. So there is a implicit discussion about area studies and ethnic studies, just like earlier with the book. And the thing is, there is a particular leaning towards ASEAN cultural forms such as anime. So this is an article by Dr. Correa regarding anime, not only in the Philippine context but also outside the Philippines. So apart from text, there are also visuals. So that's the thing. So you need to ask permission to make use of this copyrighted material. But this is an open access book. So there are several parts of the article, and there are also graphics and citation and references. So the next article is about Hallyu. So I believe you are all familiar with Hallyu, or the Korean New Wave. So we are fond consumers of Korean drama in the Philippines. So this is an article contributed by Rose Carmel Lacuata. So there's an abstract, very similar to what you're going to submit in class. There are keywords, and of course, there's an introduction and some graphics, screenshots from the K-drama that are being viewed, no, by the consumers. So in the end, there's also the references and citations. So I believe these are all contents. So you could also take a look at the rest of the book, and you could download it for free because it's an open access book. So the idea is, since we're an academic institution, it's the motive is not to gain profit but to produce knowledge. So on that note, I hope you'd be able to discover it for yourself, and we will discuss and unpack some of the details as presented in the first part with the diagram, and in the second part regarding the structure and the description of the task of the literature club. So thank you and good morning once again.